Hello everyone, welcome po sa Link Paul Champion, and today episode I show you how to do a whited ring with your Sony camera. First you have to download the imagingedge.sony.net that you will find the description below, and here you can choose whether you use Windows or iMac. So first you have to download it. And of course, you have to set your Sony camera. In this case, is the A7III. You have to go to control with the smartphone. Make sure that this is turned off. All right. So then you go to the briefcase, and then go to USB connection. Make sure this is PC remote. Okay. And then go down to PC remote setting, and you can choose whether you would like to set to PC or camera only. Okay. And of course you have to buy a tether wire. In this case I buy yung tether tools, they call Tether Pro. Actually connector to, I make it a point na itong wire na to ay magagamit ko in every type of camera. That's why ito yung binili ko, parang connector talaga siya. And I will show you how to connect. In A7III meron siyang yung micro USB. So you have to put the micro USB, and then ilagay nyo na yung ating connector na Tether Pro. Of course yung USB i-connect natin sa ating laptop. Of course turn on your camera and then go to your laptop. Open the Imaging Edge app. So meron tayong tatlong klase: remote, viewers, and edit. So in this video, we will show you mostly sa remote and some of the viewers thing, no? So here mag-start tayo. Start the remote. And then makikita nyo yung kung anong camera ang naka-connect dyan. Okay? Kapag hindi siya nakikita, just refresh it. Okay? Just double click. And then this is the actual view of your camera, no? So kung makikita nyo, di-discuss natin yung basic lang, alright? Yung basic na function nitong Remote Imaging Edge app, alright? Here makikita nyo, meron siyang rotate. Pwede nyo siya i-rotate, no? I think one of the best feature ng app na to ay itong display overlay. Itong overlay nito magagamit to sa sa mga stop motion photography. Magsasample tayo, we will take one photo. And then click natin. Magkakameron siya ng arrow doon. And then you say how much transparency you want, 50%, and you have a resolution and blah blah blah. And then just wait, pupunta tayo doon sa GoPro. Lilipat natin siya ng konti position. So nakita nyo, yung old photos at saka yung recent shot na gagawin nyo ay makikita nyo. So makikita nyo talaga siya. And then meron tayo ditong display guide. Ito maganda to, no? Para sa yung guide nyo kung saan nyo lang ipo-focus siya. Kung lalo na pag may mga product photography kayo, no? Maganda rin to. And then of course itong grid line. So grid line, marami siya, no? Meron siyang mga rule of third, of course. Kung makikita nyo rin, pwede nyo siyang itik yung line niya, no? Marami siya. Meron siyang loose grid, yung mga medium grid, so and so forth, no? So, pwede nyo siyang gamitin. So, ito yung ating focus guide. And then, yung AF na to, ito yung half shutter, and then magpo-focus siya. Siyang ilaw. So, pwede nyo siyang kumuha ng picture. Right? Tanggalin muna natin to kasi automatic to, guys, napunta sa viewer pag i-clap yung chat. Tinanggal muna natin siya for the sake of the video. And half shutter mo, and then you can take a photo. Of course, yung video button dito, meron dyan. We have also for normal, manual mode. This manual, no, you can change only in the camera, not in this app. Okay, but the rest, no, the shutter speed, the f-stop, the ISO you can change here, right? Of course, yung RAW for the photos, pwede nyo rin ganyan. White balance, you can change here also. And one thing more, if you see this focus area, if you put in wide in zone area, you cannot see that type of guide, no? You have to use the flexible focusing guide only to be able to see in your app, alright? Of course, the autofocus, you can change here also the autofocus. I mean, if you want to manual it on the camera, you can do so. And also, you can do also here. This arrow, near and far, you can do it here. And of course, the histogram, meron din siyang histogram dyan. And of course, kung saan mo siya pwedeng isave, alright? So now, I will show you, I think ito yung mga mas lagi kong ginagamit. Itong viewer, no? Ibalik muna natin ito. Let's go to the setting and then display preview in viewer. Every time I take the shot, yun yung lumalabas kanina. No? Now, we will talk the sample photo at lalabas na yung viewer. Okay? So, ito yung lagi na for me, no? Lagi kong ginagamit dahil dito, every shot that you will do, makikita mo na sa sagat in the big screen. Kasi minsan dun sa screen ng camera, akala mo okay siya, maganda yung focus, sharp siya. Pero pagdating sa desktop, sa laptop, eh medyo may problema. Kaya, I think this app or this setup is most used sa mga studio shoot. Okay? This is win-win situation dahil hindi lang yung photographers makikita niya agad nila yung outcome, no? The same time, may client rin kasi na during the shoot, eh gusto niya lang makita kung maganda yung mga shoot na ginagawa mo. At siyempre ano rin to, no? Minsan nadadala rin to sa labas, no? Kasi pag very sunny day, no? Hindi mo makita dun sa maliit na screen ng camera. So lumalabas sila nito. Ang pinakamaganda pa nito, guys, ano to, free to. Wala tong bayad kasi merong mga iba na ano eh, may bayad. So ito wala to at nagagawa rin to, guys, nagagawa rin to sa Lightroom. Pwede rin tong gawin sa Lightroom. At in this case, Imaging Edge is exclusively for Sony camera. So guys, sana meron kayong natutunan o tip na pwede nyo i-apply sa inyong photography setup o skills, no? At siyempre maraming salamat sa mga nanonood ngayon at saka sa sumusuporta sa League Photos and Film. At kung hindi pa kayo nakasubscribe, guys, ha, huwag nyo nang kalimutan na mag-subscribe sa League Photos and Film. And of course, next week po, Friday, once again, babalik po ang League Photos and Film dahil dito, hindi ka mag-iisa. Bye-bye!